The Vajra was a short story written by the famous British author William Somerset Maugham. This short story was taken from the collection of stories called Cosmopolitan. In this video, I am going to tell you the characters, setting, outline summary, round versus flat characters, narrator's point of view, style, themes, and moral of the short story, The Vajra. The characters involved in this short story were Albert Edward Foreman, who is a Vajra. Vajra is a church officer who takes care of the interior building and acts as an attendant during religious ceremonies in a church. Next, Vajra's wife, Vikar, two general wardens. Vikar and two general wardens are the higher officers working in a church. And finally, the bank officer. The setting of the short story took place in London. Now, let us move to the outline summary. Scene 1. Church at St. Peter's Neville Square in London. Once there lived a Vajra named Albert Edward Foreman, who had been Vajra in a church for the past 16 years. Albert Edward Foreman was a 28 years old, tall and dignified man who used to wear his Vajra's gown, which he got it from his predecessor. He wore the gown with a huge respect, as the gown is the symbol of his office. He took it off only when he reached his home. Later, he would wash, iron, lay it inside his wardrobe by wrapping up in a brown paper with utmost care. One afternoon in a church at St. Peter's Neville Square, Albert Edward Foreman, the Vajra, had been waiting for a vicar. Vicar was a recently appointed new higher officer who was a red-faced man in the early 40s, and he had come from East End. After completing all his works, Albert Edward Foreman, the Vajra, was waiting for the arrival of the vicar so that he could go home. Little later, the vicar arrived, but he told that he wanted to talk for a minute with the Vajra at Vestry. Vestry is a room in a church where the priest used to put on his robes. Scene 2. Vestry in a church. As per the request of vicar, the Vajra went to meet him at Vestry. There he saw two general wardens waiting for him with vicar. Suddenly, the Vajra was quite surprised, uneasy, and questioned why had he been called for the meeting. As soon as entering the vestry, the Vajra greeted both the general wardens. The general wardens were the elderly men. Both of them had been church wardens almost as long as Albert Edward had been working as Vajra in this church. Then the vicar came forward and told the Vajra that he had been working here for 16 years and done his duties as best as he could. But the most astonishing thing was that the Vajra didn't know either to read or write. Hence, the vicar told the Vajra that they cannot have a Vajra who could neither read nor write. And then the vicar warned the Vajra to learn within 3 months of time. To which the Vajra replied that he had been in service from the age of 12. After joining us, the Vajra, at the age of 12, the Vajra tried to learn from the cook. But as the days passed by, he said that he didn't find enough time to learn, and also told that his wife would help him in writing a letter, and he could come to know the news through the pictures in the newspaper. After, the verger told that he was afraid to learn at this age. Suddenly, the vicar told the verger to quit his job. And so, the verger left the church politely without arguing anything with the new vicar and the two elderly general wardens. Scene 3 in London Streets. After leaving the church, Albert Edward Forman became very sad. Hence, he didn't want to go to his home. Rather, he walked in streets, searching for the tobacco shop to buy a packet of gold flakes because he felt that cigarettes would comfort him. But he could not find a single tobacco shop in the street. Suddenly, he got an idea to start tobacco business. He took the matter very seriously, and so he quitted his verger job within a month. Few days later, by good luck, he had found a little shop in the street and began his tobacco business. Soon after becoming a tobacconist, he gained more profit from it. In the course of 10 years, he started 10 tobacco shops in the streets of London where there was no tobacco shop before. Eventually, he became a very successful businessman. And every Monday, he would visit all his 10 tobacco shops, collected money and deposited them in the bank. Scene 4. Bank. One day, when he went bank to deposit £30,000, the bank officer told him to invest it so that he could gain interest from the bank. The bank officer informed Albert Edward Forman to sign in the form when he comes to bank next time. For which Albert Edward Forman asked him what was written in the form. Suddenly, the bank officer shocked to know that the successful businessman didn't know either to read or write. Then the bank officer further asked him what would he be then if he had been able to read and write. To which Albert Edward Forman, with a little smile on his face, told that he would have been a verger of St. Peter Neville Square. With this, the short story ends. By telling the bank manager that he would be the verger of St. Peter's, Albert Edward managed to show humility. He had not forgotten where he came from, nor did he wish to change his past. Albert Edward had made a success out of his life and remained humble throughout the story. In this short story, Albert Edward Forman, the vicar, and the two general wardens were all the flat characters who remained the same throughout the story. This short story was set in third-person point of view by an unnamed narrator, and the author used simple language and no complex words. You can read this story in one sitting with only one main plot and limited number of characters and no subplots. And the possible themes that involved in this short story were illiteracy, appearance, opportunity, dedication, humility, and independence. This short story, the verger, showed how an illiterate man could earn more money and wealth because of his smart thinking. Thank you.